Ho-ho! Thank you. Phoemia ignatus is another of the island's generally docile herd animals. They are small enough that almost any predator can bring them down, but large enough to provide plenty of meat. Were it not for the protection of the herd and the instinct of any predator, these would almost certainly be hunted to extinction. Phoemia's tusks and trunk make it especially suited to scavenging plant life on the ground. It uses its tusks to scoop plant life, then uses its stubby trunk to scoop the foliage into its mouth. Adult Phoemia often dig up food for their young, and watching a baby Phoemia attempt to use its trunk, while it is completely possible to ride a Phoemia, they are a meager choice. As pack mules. If you feed the Phoemia a stimberry, it serves as a laxative in the creature's digestive system. Knowing this, tribal communities often keep a herd of these as a to keep mass quantities of fertilizer.
Thank you.
Bistrosaurus amicifidelis is a small herbivore, common to much of the island. Only about 2 feet long, it is not high on the food chain and eats small plant life. The island's poisonous insects seem to have little effect on Lystrosaurus. Despite being among the island's tinier herbivores, Lystrosaurus is an incredibly resilient survivor. It recovers its torpor and health much faster than most creatures, which makes rendering a Lystrosaurus unconscious a rather difficult affair. Not surprisingly, Lystrosaurus is an extremely loyal pet once tamed. It's a very fast learner, so it gains experience much more quickly than most other creatures. Additionally, its presence nearby appears to inspire allies, making them learn more rapidly as well. Thusly, Lystrosaurus is an excellent addition to any type of seeing the likes of Mammothus steinkaput alongside dinosaurs is still strange. This behemoth towers over many creatures on the island and doesn't seem to fear anything but the Tyrannosaurus. I've seen them stomp different predators out of their way. Mammoths can grab and throw things with their powerful trunks and manage a fearsome trumpeting roar with them as well. At first, I wondered how herds of mammoths were able to find enough plant life to graze on. But then I saw them sweeping up thatch and foliage with their tusks and stomping branches out of trees. Mammoths generally thrive in colder areas and have a herd mentality. They must spend much of their time traveling between the mountain's cold summit and more lush base, and maybe their herds are the reason why the summits are so barren. Mammothus steinkaput is a difficult beast to domesticate. Not because they are inherently stubborn, but because not everyone else is in the Once tamed, however, mammoths are one of the only creatures on the island that can uproot trees without shattering them, and their trunks are strong enough to lift and carry survivors and other smaller creatures. Lately, survivors have been saddling up their mammoths to ride in tandem. The more clever riders have even been outfitting their mammoth saddles with war drums. Turns out, the mammoths
I Thank you.